Re-enlisting in November 2011 at Forward Operating Base in Frontenac, Afghanistan, U.S. Army Staff Sergeant Brian Beam continues to actively serve his country, despite the loss of his right leg to a roadside bomb in Baghdad that tragically claimed the life of a team member in October 2006. Beam, joined by 13 other combat wounded warriors, is also serving fellow soldiers and civilians alike at a University of South Florida School of Physical Therapy and Rehabilitation Sciences research study, evaluating how well different types of prosthetic feet work for the rigors and agile maneuvers soldiers must perform on the battlefield. The study will ultimately benefit civilian amputees with physically challenging occupations, such as firefighters and police officers, or anyone with physically demanding recreational pursuits, says USF Assistant Professor Dr. Jason Highsmith, who is leading the study.
Our findings are going to have implications not only for rehabilitation of soldiers that seek to stay on active duty, but also for folks that have an amputation that want to participate in society at a more intense level, participating in things like triathlons, running, things like that for the most part. But also, again, the measures of efficiency will have implications for normal gait, normal walking, normal jogging at a comfortable pace.
The double-blind randomized trial enrolls 28 physically fit people. Half are highly functioning amputee soldiers and veterans. The other 14, the control group, are non-amputees, including accomplished civilian athletes and law enforcement officers. As the number of soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan with deployment-related amputations continue to rise dramatically, USF Health researchers are proudly upping the ante on the scientific rigor applied to prosthetic research.
I take it with a badge of pride that one of the places I worked, it took 3 months for my boss to realize I was an amputee.